So let us take a look at what is a cognitive system. Notice that I'm using the term cognitive system and not the term knowledge-based AI agent. I could have used that term also. When we talk about knowledge-based AI agent, then we can take two views. One view is that we're going to build a knowledge-based AI system, which need not be human-like. Another view is that the knowledge-based AI agent that we will build will be human-like. The cognitive system is situated in the world. Here by the world, I mean the physical world. For example, the world that I am interacting with right now, with this screen in front of me and this microphone. This world has percepts in it. As an example, the percept of something being a straight line, or a color of some object, or the smoothness of the texture of some object. These percepts are in the world, and the cognitive system is using sensors to perceive these percepts. That's the input of the cognitive system. The cognitive system also has some actuators. So for example, I have fingers that I'm using right now to point to things. And a cognitive system uses actuators to carry on actions in the world. The cognitive system then is taking percepts as input and giving actions as output. So far, we have talked about a single cognitive system. But of course, one can have multiple cognitive systems. These multiple cognitive systems can interact with each other. Just like a cognitive system is situated in a physical world, it is also situated in a social world. Let us now zoom into the inside of a cognitive system. What is the architecture of a cognitive system? So the cognitive system takes as input certain percepts about the world. It has the task of giving as output actions of the world. The question then becomes, how can these percepts be mapped into actions? One way of mapping them is that we will do a direct mapping. These percepts will be directly mapped into actions. Let's take an example. Imagine that you're driving a car and the brake lights of the car in front of you become bright red. Should that happen, you will then press on the brakes of your car. Well, that is an example of a reactive system. The percepts were that the brake lights of the car in front of you became bright red, and the action was that you pressed on your own brakes. In doing so, you may not have planned. This is now a direct mapping of percepts into actions. Alternatively, consider a slightly different problem. Again, you're driving your car on the highway, but as you're trying to drive on the highway, your task this time is to change lanes. Now, in order to change lanes, again, you may look around and look at the percepts of the world. There are other cars on the road, for example, and you have to take some action that will help you change lanes. This time, you may actually deliberate. You may actually look at the goal that you have, as well as the percepts of the environment, and come up with a plan that will tell you what action to take. As we discussed in the last lesson, the deliberation itself has a number of components in it. Three of the major components that we'll be studying in this class are learning, reasoning, and memory. These three components interact with each other in many interesting ways that we will decipher as we go along. Now, deliberation was reasoning about the world around us. So if I take that example again of changing lanes as I'm driving on the highway, then I'm reasoning about the world around me. Where are the other cars? Should I change lanes to the left or to the right? Metacognition, on the other hand, the third layer here, has to do with reasoning about the internal mental world. So metacognition reasons about the deliberation, or metacognition can also reason about reaction. Let us take an example of the metacognition also. Imagine again that I have to change lanes, and as I change lanes to the left, the cars behind me honk, because I did not leave enough space for the car that was already moving on the left lane. In that case, I know that the lane changing did not go very smoothly. I may now think about my own actions in the world, about the deliberation that led to those actions, and may then decide to change or reconfigure or repair the deliberation that led to that suboptimal plan for changing the lanes. That is an example of metacognition. So now I have this three-layered architecture: reaction, deliberation, metacognition. Note that we have defined intelligence in a way. Intelligence here is about mapping percepts in the world into actions in the world. Intelligence is about selecting the right kind of action given a particular state of the world. But there are many different ways in which we can map the percepts into actions. Purely reactive, deliberative, or also entailing metacognition on the deliberation and the reaction. This then is the overall architecture of the cognitive system. This is called the three-layered architecture. We'll be returning to this architecture many times in this course.